I think Rachel could use another subject.
But which one?
That's the one.
This light needs more light. Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight. All ready for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first. Hey, check it out.
It's beautiful.
I thought you might like it.
I've always loved stars.
Why?
It reminds us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see.
Because we're blinded by what's in front of us.
Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
Take it, even if it's only by process of elimination.
Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone. The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me, I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Honestly, I have no idea what's right or wrong in this situation. I just know that whatever you decide, I'm in.
But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right. Dad, I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go?
Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
We never... That wasn't... you.
Could have sworn that was me. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Like what? There's nothing here.
Really? That's odd. Well, I know it's not the spark plug. I just got that replaced.
What?
I said it's not the spark plug!
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about stories told by idiots, full of sound and fury, signifying fuck all.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a... bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Okay. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. He might also be totally pissed about Damon's money. I've got to get this exactly right. I can do this.
Price.
Oh, Frank. Eager much?
Where's the money?
I have a question to ask you first. I mean, a favor.
You can't be fucking serious.
I need to find that woman from yesterday. Sarah. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I'm trying to help a friend. It would mean a whole lot to her.
The girl with you at the mill?
Yeah.
I'll be in the junkyard in 2 hours.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real... That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into? Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing. Is Mom playing music? Huh. Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. My towel's probably in here somewhere. I should just calmly look for it. Lots of washcloths. No towel. Score. Can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate. We never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my life. Hot water, don't let me down. I need new clothes. What do I feel like wearing on this crazy ass day? All right, one last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. Better than nothing. Dad's favorite jacket. Definitely taking that if Rachel and I ever leave. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you, 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
I'm also glad you came home, Chloe.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh. Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you. It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
Chloe.
I don't have time for this.
Now, hold on a minute. Please. I owe you an apology.
Let's hear it.
Chloe, I should not have asked you to empty your pockets yesterday. I was, out of line, and I'm sorry.
Okay. Apology accepted.
Really?
Yeah. Good job. And good job, Mom, for twisting his arm or whatever.
Chloe.
What? It's great. He listens to you. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck. Come on. Work with me here. Better, but still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. Need to find the right tool for each problem. It's not like I need a manual, but I'm really glad it's here. This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. Not helping. This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else. Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be. This thing is gunked the fuck up. It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Much better. Maybe. Sick. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. That should help keep shit distributed. Well, fuck. Go back from whence you came. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course. Please, I need you.
Junkyard Queen, where are you at? Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so...
badass.
I was gonna say hot. But, yeah, badass too. Hey, not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
What do you think? We're not dealing with a couple of dime bags anymore, Chloe. Where's the money?
For fuck's sake, the money wasn't there. What do you want from me?
I don't think she has it.
Oh? It's cute how she acts like you two are friends. You heard what happened to Drew, right? Maybe try keeping that in mind when you talk to me.
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing. Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you. But he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know, right now, why you give a shit about this woman?
Why do you care so much?
Because... fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is. Now,
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know.
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither, but I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
Oh, you fucking bitch!
Chloe! Go! Now!
Hold on!
Shit! 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 Chloe!
Hey! Just hold on, okay? Rachel? No, no, no! No! I'm not losing you.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery, and now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
It's my fault. I should have listened to you. Sarah's mixed up somehow with this psycho Damon Merrick.
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe, but I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
He asked us why we were so interested in Sarah.
And what did you say?
Nothing, of course.
Is that how it became violent?
It was actually Rachel who got angry. She was furious that he wouldn't tell her where Sarah was.
This is exactly what I've been afraid of. Rachel won't let anything stop her.
It wasn't only that. She was already angry about Damon pushing me around.
She is like her mother. Quick-tempered, rash. I've always been afraid of losing her the way I lost Sarah. What happened next?
Damon had a knife out. We all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something. But when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream. but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth. I'll see if I can pull some strings with Ray. Maybe get you back into Blackwell.
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive. First of all, my department's been after him for some time. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
Hey.
Steph, how's Drew?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay, sure. Definitely. I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up.
All right, then. Thank you.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
Here to see Drew?
Yeah. How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. Drew's hurt, of course. But there's other things going well for us. I'm moving back into my old apartment in 2.5 hours. I don't know if you know this, but, Mikey's been crashing at Drew's dorm.
Oh?
I had a bit of trouble with work. And it's all been pretty hard. Anyway, Drew managed to scrape together enough to get me back on my feet.
I'm glad things are starting to work out then.
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now. I have a question maybe you can answer.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well, guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
You should probably ask Drew. I don't really know any details. I do know that whatever it is, they did it because they wanted to help you.
Thanks, Chloe. They actually have helped me out, money-wise. We're a family, you know? We deal with things together. Oh, excuse me.
Hey!
You made it.
Oh. Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Drew.
How's your knee doing? Do they think it's gonna heal?
I'm not sure, actually. It's too early to tell.
Sorry to hear it.
It's all good.
Love the hair, by the way.
Pretty cool.
Thanks. Just, trying it out.
Sometimes you've just gotta do something new. Hey, any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
Rachel's stable. She'll probably wake up soon.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
What happened?
She got stabbed in the arm by demon fucking Merrick.
Seriously? It wasn't because of me, was it?
No. Somehow, we've got our own shit with him now.
That's crazy.
Fuck that guy! I wish I could get my hands on him.
Drew, chill out, okay?
I'm headed out. Everything okay in here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Don't have too much fun now. Try to keep it appropriate for the hospital.
Bye, Dad.
See ya, Pops.
Man. Maybe I shouldn't have mentioned Damon. Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready. Ooh, I want to eat that. Right now. I wonder if Drew will ever play again. Look at that. Wells being nice for a change. That'll be an interesting read. All right. I'm gonna head out.
It was really great to see you, Chloe.
Agreed. Don't be a stranger, okay?
Yeah?
Tell Rachel we're rooting for her.
You bet.